Dear friends and students, welcome back to my channel for the subject SolidWorks in 21 days in this lockdown period. Today is day 2. Let us see about what we have seen in the last session. In the last session, we saw about the introduction about the SolidWorks. We saw that it's a parametric modeling software. The first exercise was how to draw a cylinder. It's a solid. Cylinder is a solid with a diameter of 60 and height 90. So with that exercise, we saw about the terminologies. The terminologies are, the sketch is nothing but a two-dimensional entity. So for this exercise, for example, you have to draw a circle of diameter 60. Then you have to extrude it through this feature. You will get a solid. So in that first exercise, I told you about how to define or how to constrain a sketch. There are two ways of constraining it. Constraining or defining using dimension. Second, using relations. You should use both actually, but give more priority and preference to the relation. To the maximum possible extent, use the relations, then use the dimension. Okay. So, as a good CAD engineer, your sketch or the feature or the part either should be underdefined or fully defined. Okay. If it is overdefined, it is wrong. It will not allow you to proceed further. Okay, that we will see in the next sessions actually. Okay, now we'll solve some more simple problems to start with. Okay, then slowly because we have 21 days, you know, so this is day 2. So after some time, slowly we'll be seeing some more complex exercises, okay, in the due course. To draw, so we'll be solving at least 3, 4, or 5 exercises in this session, in the today's session actually. To draw a pentagonal prism of base side 25mm and height maybe 70mm. Okay, so that is the exercise given to us now. Okay, so here the base is a pentagon and height is 70. So the base is a sketch. So first you have to draw a sketch. Okay. This one I will show you by drawing in by selecting any of the 3 principal planes. Okay, now go to SolidWorks, type new, click the part, press OK. Now you have entered in. Now there are 3 different planes available to draw a sketch to start with. Front plane, these are the principal planes I can say. Front plane, top plane, right plane. You can choose any one. Okay, you can choose any one and you can go for the sketch. You can press the button here. Or otherwise, if you press the button here, you will be asked, you will be shown 3 different principal planes. You can choose any one. So you can choose this one. If you move the cursor here, you see the top plane is red in color. That means you are about to choose that one. Otherwise, you are about to choose the right plane. Otherwise, you are about to choose the front plane. So this is one way. Okay. Again, I repeat. You can click. You can select any one of the principal and plane here, and you can go for sketch. Or otherwise, insert. These are the different sketch tools available, of course. Okay. Anyway, so I'll go this way now. Okay. I'll be solving. Okay. Let me close this one. I'll solve this one by selecting one. This one. I'll be completing that. I'll be erasing the solid and I'll be creating a fresh solving the same problem by choosing the front plane. Second option. Third option, the right plane. Okay, let me choose this one first. So I am into this sketch. Whenever you get a symbol, this into mark and this this symbol, that means you are inside the sketch. That means you are about to draw the two-dimensional entities. Two-dimensional entities means that you are naturally a two-dimensional entity composing of lines and arcs. Okay. Now here you have these many sketch tools are available, and under the tools pull-down menu bar, the sketch entities. These many sketch entities you have: line, rectangle, different types of four different types of rectangles, parallelogram, the slots, polygon, circle, arcs in three or four different ways, ellipse, parabola, etc., etc. So the minimal thing, it is available in the command bar itself. So now you see that this is the command button for the polygon. Polygon means it starts from polygon of three side triangle, equilateral triangle. So you can start by clicking this button. You can start drawing right from the three sided equilateral triangle up to even a polygon of side 1000, or to be in practical terms, a polygon of 10 sides is equal to decagon. So from triangle to decagon, you can use this command. Okay, now let me click this one. The moment I click this, a dialog box will appear here. So you are about to draw the number of sides of the polygon. 6 means hexagon. But what is the x size given? What is the x size? We have a pentagonal prism of base side 25 mm, height 70 mm. Okay, so now you type 5. Okay, then you move the sketch. Now you see, as per this sketch, I'll be draw the polygon, the pentagon here, by inscribing in a circle method. Okay, so I'll show you now. Click the center. If you move this way, you are about to draw the polygon such that one side, the bottom side, is parallel horizontal. If I go this way, the left edge is vertical. If you go this way, all are somewhat inclined. Okay, so I'll go this way. Okay, so now click, press escape. I'm sorry, I previously said the inscribing circle. I'm sorry, it is not inscribing circle, it is circumscribing over the circle. This pentagon, a five-sided polygon, has been drawn, circumscribed over this particular circle. Okay, we could say this circle is a pitch circle, maybe, right? Now you see the line type of this circle is something like a chain line type. Okay, now I'll tell you now, time has come. Now this is the command. Time being, you forget about this polygon now. I will explain what are the two different types of two different line types that you have. Okay, along with the exercise, I will be telling you about two line types. Object line construction line. Okay, the object line is a thick continuous line type, whereas the construction line is a chain line or a center line. Okay, I'll show you. This is the line command available here. If you press this one, now you see the line type. It is a continuous line type. Whereas instead of clicking here, click this pull down bar, the center line. I'm drawing a line again here. You see the difference. It is a chain line. Okay, so you have the two different line types here in SolidWorks. So whenever you are drawing an entity using this continuous line type, okay, that is the these are the object lines. Instead, if you use this line type, it is called a construction line type, or you can use it as a, it won't come under the part of the object, right? So here the five lines of this pentagon are the object lines. The circle, it is not of a thick continuous line type. That means it is a construction line type. It is not the part of the object actually, right? That is what you have in SolidWorks. Again, I repeat, you have two different line types. Okay. So again, I will show you. You can draw any. Sorry. Let me erase. I have drawn, so this triangle is an object actually, okay. So the construction line is a graph sheet. So graph sheet is nothing but it is having a grid lines, okay. With the help of the grid lines only, you will be plotting the point, marking the points, and you are drawing the curve. Okay, the curve is the object there. The grid lines are not the objects. Those are for your reference only. Okay, same as that. Okay, so whatever profiles that you draw using this line type, continuous line type, okay, that is the object lines. It is not the object. If you draw the same object using this line type, it won't be considered as an object. Okay, you are using that as for the construction purpose. Something like you are using the grid lines or the graph for drawing the plotting the curve. Okay, I'll delete this one. Now you see it is blue in color. Why? Whenever it is blue in color, you will be having a minus sign here. You'll be having a text somewhat like undefined. Okay. Now let us see how to define it, because we haven't defined about the size. Okay. What is the size? The base side is 25. Okay. So let me use the dimension now 25 is marked. After 25 is marked, you see still all the edges are blue in color. Again, it shows undefined. Okay, to define it fully, I'll tell you, select this one. The moment you select this one, it will automatically, you see some of the blips, you could see these are the relations already marked by the SolidWorks software itself on its own. Okay, it is having some intelligence, maybe artificial intelligence. Okay, again I repeat, the moment I select this vertical line, you could see some of the blip marks. These are the relations, auto relations actually put in, embedded already while drawing the profile. Then you see there are additional possible relations that you can try. If you press this one, you can make this horizontal. If you press this, you can make it vertical or fix. Let me press the vertical button here. You carefully see that now it is blue in color, everything is blue in color. The moment I click the vertical button, you see what happens. The moment I click this one, everything becomes black. Now it shows fully defined. So this is how you can define any object. Now I'll make it more defined. Now I'll be using another dimension. It is not allowing, it is automatically while experimenting this way, what it says, even in dimension, again two types of dimensions. One is driving, another one is driven. I'll erase this one. I think you have seen about the equation already. Okay, there are two types of dimensions. Okay, one is driving, another one is driven. That means I can't. This is, you see, the color difference between this dimension and this dimension. It is slightly gray in color. If I double click this one, I cannot edit its value because it is driven. Whereas if I double click this one, I can edit. I can change the value. Now let me show you. Okay, instead of 25, I'll put it to 15. You see, it has been reduced. But this is automatically be varying. Because it is driven, it is not a driving one. Okay, previously it was having some value of I think 17 or something. Now it is 12.7. Now again I go back to 25. Okay, so that is like. I am about to show you about the word defined, but still the software is not allowing me. Okay, now I'll try. I select this line. I'll try to make this vertical. Yeah. Now you see. Moment I select, already this edge is vertical. How come this could be a vertical then? That is why you see the item is unsolvable. You see some error message will be coming. Invalid solution found. Even after that, if you select this one. Okay, so these are the indications that this software will not allow you to move further. This is called something similar to the overdefining. Okay, so overdefine, you see the circle color red in color. Okay, either the entity color is red or a light yellow, that means the sketch or the object is under overdefined. Okay, overdefined is not advisable. It won't, the software will not allow you to go by overdefined. Sometimes you cannot proceed further, of course. Okay, so what I have to do, choose that one. I have to delete the overdefined parameter. The moment I delete this one, you see it is fully defined. There is no minus symbol here. Okay, so over. So we go back to the exercise. Where is the exercise? Yeah, this is the exercise. Let me do one thing. The exercise should be in red in color always. Okay, so that is a easy way of doing it. I'll be following this word file till for this 21 days. Right? So this 25 is over. We have to add the 70. Okay, this one is over now. Exit from the sketch, then select the sketch, go for boss extrude, otherwise go in the top view mode, select this one, insert boss. You can go this way also. Either in the command bar you can use this button, or in the menu you can go by boss extrude. So two ways are possible actually. So what is the height given here? 70 mm. Okay, here type 70, press OK. That's it. It is a pentagonal prism of side 25 and height 70. Now this is the front view, this is the side view, this is the top view, this is the isometric view. As per the line diagram, this is the front view, this is the left side view. This is the right side view. In the left side view, one edge is completely normal, vertical edge is not visible, that is hidden. In the right side view, two vertical edges are hidden. Top view, isometric. In the isometric view, top pentagon is visible. Okay. In the isometric view, two major vertical faces are hidden. Okay. If you want to see only the visible edges, hidden lines are removed. So like that, you can see that the different views. If you want to change the color, okay, color is not so important, but of course, for aesthetics, you can add some color also here. Okay, so again, I repeat, this is the button for the color. Okay, so that's it. I'll save this as exercise 2. Okay, so this is over. Now let us see, this is front view, no? This is top view. I keep it in front view. Side by side, I'll be slowly adding some more thing. How to get drawing from this file? Already I saved this file as EX2, exercise 2. The extension for the part file is, the solid model file is SLDPRT. So EX2 is the exercise name. This is the file extension. SLDPRT means this is a part file. SolidWorks part file. Solid part file. Now slowly I will be adding some more things. How to always the question part, I'll be using red color. Okay. How to get the drawing from the part? Okay. So this is additional information I'll be giving you. How to get a drawing from the part file. Okay, see, because for all the three-dimensional objects, you have to get a drawing from it. Then only you can pass on that drawing information to the worker. Thereby, the worker can make that particular component. Okay. Now, for that, you open a separate file. File, new, drawing. Okay. So drawing is a derivative of either part or assembly file. Drawing file can be created afresh separately, but it is not so, not required that way. Drawings can be derived from the part file or from the assembly file. Okay, I already told you about the part assembly drawing, but again I'll be repeating. Part is a solid file, a solid model. If you have more than one parts, more than two parts, then only you can go for assembly. So if at all, if you want to do some assembly work, create more parts, then only you can go for assembly. But when it comes to drawing, you should have either part file or assembly file. From that, you can get a drawing. You can get the drawing of either part or assembly as a derivative. So click this one, press OK. Then it will ask sizes, say A0 size or A4 size, something it will show. Let me choose my custom size actually, A4, because let me click this one, because title box will appear. I don't want it, that one actually. So 210 by 297 is the A4 size. Or better, safe side, A3 size, 427 by 420. Okay, a blank file without any title block. Okay, press escape. Now you see in the window you have exercise part file, exercise number 2 part file. See carefully. And I opened a new file called DRAW sheet 1 drawing. Okay. Now, this is the command bar for the drawing, to get the drawing from either part or the assembly. Now, press this one, model view, note down. For drawing, you have to press model view button. Okay, so press model view. The moment you press the model view button, a model view dialog box will appear. Here you see already the path file is in opened now. Okay, that will be listed here. So already it has been selected. If you have more, you'll have a list. You have to choose anyone. But already we have opened only one part file. The part file name is EX2 exercise 2 solid. So click this one. Then see carefully, go to next. Then I press escape now for time being. If you press control tab, you can go to the part file. Now it is in this view, it is in the front view. Okay, press model view, already EX2 is listed. Go to next menu. Current, I want to check the current model view as the front view. So select this one. Then hidden lines visible. Then use custom scale 1:1 scale. So these are the minimal things important that we require as mechanical engineer. Okay. So press the model view. Already EX2 file is highlighted. Go to next page. Set the current model view as your front view. Okay. Then hidden line visible. You select. Then previously it will be in use sheet scale, but better use custom scale, and you can choose this one 1:1. So now you see you can place the drawing obtained from that part file, to be obtained from the part file. So this is the front view, this is the corresponding top view, corresponding right side view, corresponding left side view, and isometric view. Okay, press escape button, you can exit from the sketch. I move this one separately. Okay, now you see front view, top view. So if you want to move this one, it can be moved only in the vertical direction, because you can move separately. This can be moved in the horizontally only. So this is how you can get the drawing. Or here what I obtained is these four drawings is nothing but the orthographic view: front view, side view, top view. Front view, top view, side view, and of course isometric view also I obtained. Okay, press tick mark. So this is over. Now let me save this one. I am saving it as exercise 2, same as the part file, but you see the extension SLD DRW. SLD DRW means drawing file, SLD DRT means part file. So it is saved. So you have exercise part file and exercise sheet, the drawing file. Then note down one more thing: insert model items. Insert model items. Press tick button. The moment you did so, insert model items, press OK. Whatever dimensions that you have given, you know, that will be inserted here. So the next step for this one is insert model items. If you use in the insert menu bar, if you click the insert model items, then the dimensions will be also printed in the drawing file also. Okay, so that is how you can show the dimensions here. You see these two dimensions are driving dimensions. These two are driving dimensions. What I mean is, here both associativity property. Whether the spelling is correct or not, let me check. Yeah, spelling is not correct. Let us not waste our time. Associativity, okay, associativity property. The associativity property means this is the drawing file. Control tab if you use, you can go to the model file. Let me keep it in isometric mode. Whatever changes that you make here, that will be reflected here. Vice versa, whatever things you will be changing in these two dimensions, it will be reflected there. So because that means it has both part file and drawing file has got a link. That is nothing but the associativity. Okay, I'll show you now. Double click this one. So these are the two dimensions that I used. Click this one instead of 25. Say let it be 36, okay. But this one, now you see it is changed. Previously it was 2570, now it is 3670. Now you go to the drawing file now. Now you see it is changed. Now it is changed automatically. Previously it was 25, now it is 36. I'll change here. Let me change here in the drawing file. Instead of 70, let me put 81. Then you have to rebuild it. This is the button for rebuild or control B. Press this one. Now you see this becomes 81. This becomes 81 now. Go to part file now, double click this one. Previously it was 70, now it is 81. So that is called the associativity property. Associativity property. So this is very important. Okay. So now you see how easy it is to get not only the three different orthographic view, also the isometric view also. In general, in isometric view, especially in orthographic, we should see the hidden lines. But in general, in isometric, hidden lines we should not see at all. So only for the isometric, select this one. Okay, you can hide the visible edges, hidden edges. Sorry. So now hidden edges are removed only in the isometric diagram, but not in the orthographic view. That is also possible. Okay. So let me go back to 25, 70. Rebuild or control B. It is rebuilt. I'm saving it. Now you see, if you double click this one, now you see it is 2570. So the changes that whatever changes that I made here, it is being reflected here automatically. So that is the property, that is the associativity property of the software. So these properties will be there not only in SolidWorks software, also the softwares like PROE, Creo, CATIA, Unigraphics, and so on, because all are coming under parametric modeling software, but not in AutoCAD. Okay, AutoCAD is only meant for the drafting purpose. Okay, now we'll see another problem. Slowly we'll be adding some more complexity. So exercise 3, to draw hexagonal pyramid of side 20 and height 65. This is the third exercise. Okay, so let me close. Hereafter I think I did not explain much about how to get a drawing file. I have to create a drawing file from the part file because you know it already now. So let me save this as, okay, I'll create a fresh file for this exercise number three. File, new, part, okay. Now hexagonal pyramid means base is a hexagon, the apex or top, there is no top face for the pyramid. Top face, it is not a face actually, it is a point. Apex is a point. Okay, so here you need to draw, you cannot directly get it from the extruded bars. You have to use a different command. Okay, so now slowly we'll be seeing some more commands also now. Okay, so I'll be slightly speeding up now, maybe. Okay, you please cope up. If you're not able to understand, rewind the video and play it. Okay, you can understand easily. So sketch top plane. I have selected polygon button, this one, I'm sorry, it is a hexagon, no, in place of 5, I have to put 6, number of sides equal to 6 for hexagon. So a hexagon is made. What is the base side? 20. So use the dimension command, it is 20. Still blue in color, select this one, make it horizontal. The moment I make it horizontal, it is a fully defined, everything black in color. Okay, so this is over. Exit from the sketch. Now you cannot use the extrude or boss extrude straight away because the top portion is not a hexagonal face, it is a point. The point is at a height of 65 mm. For that, what you supposed to do is you should have a sketch point as the sketch at the top. At how much distance? At the height of 65 mm. Because that is the problem given to us. For that, you slowly, so carefully, you have to create a reference plane. These are the standard reference planes available to draw any sketch. Front plane, top plane, right plane. So always I think I have used one and only top plane. So far I haven't used front plane, right plane also. Maybe in the following exercises I'll be using that. Right? So instead of these two, you can create a reference plane or a datum plane. Some software they use reference plane, some software they use a datum plane, okay, or simply as a plane. Okay. So you need a plane for a sketch. That for the top fit, at the top there must be a point. Okay, the base is a hexagon, top is a point. Okay, if you connect these two, you will get a solid, a pyramid, hexagonal pyramid. So for that you have to create a new reference plane. So I clicked this one, the dialog box will appear. Then I expand this one, the top plane I am choosing. What is with reference this top plane, the base vertical plane, horizontal plane, sorry, it is how much distance? 65 mm. So here 65 mm, you have to put 65. Now you see the gap between this reference plane to this one is 65. You can change this value even. Okay, so this is a tight, so plane is made. Now you have to draw a sketch onto the plane. The point is the sketch in this particular case, because apex is a point. Click this one, go for sketch. That means you are inside the, your pen. You are about to scribble something onto this plane, not anywhere else. You are about to scribble something on this particular plane. Okay, normal to the plane. This is the button for point. Just click that point. Click here. And it is better you fix it. If you fix it, that cannot be moved. That cannot be moved. Press escape. Now this is the point. A point is marked. A point is marked. The point is at 0, 0 onto this particular plane. Exit from the sketch. Exit from the sketch. Go to the isometric plane. There are two sketches we have made. The base sketch is a hexagon. The top in this particular plane one, the sketch is a point. Okay. A plane is visible, you know. You can hide that particular plane if you want. Hide and show. Only if you click this plane button, that at that time alone the plane will be visible. Because it need not be visible always. Okay, so on plane one, I marked sketch two. So two sketches are made. Sketch one, a hexagon. On after that plane is created. On plane one, I have drawn a sketch two. Sketch two is a point. The plane is at a height of 65 from this base plane. That's it. Now for this pyramid you have to use a command called loft. You have to use the command called loft. Okay, here it is available. Loft R inset loft. You can choose any loft. Dialog box will appear. You have to use the two profiles. Okay. What I can do is expand this. Select these two sketches. So sketch one is selected now. I am selecting sketch two. These two sketches are selected. You see the preview. Already it is made. Press OK. That's it. That's it. So this is a front view. This is a side view. Top view. Isometric view. In the line drawing, front view, side view, top view. All edges are visible. Bottom view, base is visible. Slant edges are hidden. Isometric view. Okay, so let me save this as exercise 3. Okay, now I keep it in front view mode. Okay, I will not explain about how to get a drawing for this particular problem. Okay, I'll just do it. You see it, you can understand it. Drawing. Custom A3 size. Escape. Inset model view. Exercise 3 is selected. Next page. Hidden lines visible. Use current scale as 1:1. Front view. Oh. It follows third angle projection actually. I'm sorry. Okay, I'll check it now. Maybe not now. Maybe in the tomorrow session I'll show you about how to convert this into first angle projection method. Because as per the first angle projection method, in the top view you should see all these slant edges as visible edges. Here it shows hidden edges. Okay. Insert model items. Press OK. So dimensions included here also. I am saving it as AX3 drawing file. So this is how you can get the drawing for from the part file. Drawing from the part file. Okay. So I think for today's session, I think this is sufficient. Okay. Now before winding it up, let us see the do's and don'ts while drawing the sketch. Do some don'ts while drawing the sketch. Okay, let me close this one. Let me create a new part file. I'm not going to save this one. Okay, go for sketch. Select this one. Now I'll show you to draw a highly irregular prism. Not much explanation needed here. Now it is closed. Okay, press escape. Yeah, 10 mm height. Okay, now you see. So if I double click the sketch, I'm inside the sketch again. I'm bit faster, I believe, right? But you please cope up with me. So you see, all are well connected. All the end points are connected together. Now, if I exit, you see the shape. Again, let me get into the sketch. I am inside the sketch now. You see the symbol is available. When I double click this one, I can directly get into the sketch. Now, what I will be doing is I'll be putting some circle, maybe some different polygons. Ellipse, a different polygon. Escape. The entities which are inside the outer profile, you know, those are considered as holes. It can be a circular hole, elliptical hole, or polygonal hole. Okay, this is also allowed. Again, I go back. Now I'll be drawing a circle this way. Circle this way. It is crossing the boundary. Let us see whether it will be allowed or not. I escape this one. Now you see sketch is having some issues. It cannot rebuild the feature. It cannot rebuild the feature. So the best thing is you can erase it. Or else, now see carefully. I am introducing some more commands. You can trim some portion. Okay. Let me trim this one. This sketch is inside the boundary only, but still, if you escape, it won't work because it is a boundary. It's a confusing boundary actually. What I could do is, let me remove this portion. Now the outer boundary. Previously, the outer boundary is a straight one. Now it is a curved one. Okay, you'll have a something like a cut. Now you see, I'm not explaining much, but you could understand very well. Okay, so these are some of the parts. Let me erase this one. Let me erase this again. Let me create a new sketch. Now again, it seems that it is a closed profile. It is a closed profile. Now let me extrude this one 10 mm. Now you say sketch contains self intersecting contour. It is not possible. The point here is the sketch sketch must be a profile, close to profile. Okay, there are three possibilities: close to profile, crossed profile, open profile. The crossed profile is not at all allowed there. But the open profile is not advisable, first of all. Not advisable, first of all. But it accepts on some occasions in SolidWorks. So that is why I put both the into and the tick mark here. So sketch must be a closed profile. A circle, O, letter O is a closed profile. Letter C is an open profile. Letter X is a crossed profile. Crossed profile is not allowed. So it is a closed profile. You see that these two are crossing. Okay, either by pressing control key, select both the corners. Either you can choose the merge, or using the trim button, you can trim those extensions. So extensions were trimmed. Now if I go, it will work. So a sketch must be a closed profile to get a feature or a part. Crossed profile is not at all allowed. Open profile, I said it is not advisable, but it allows as a thin profile. Okay, again I go back, let me undo it. So I use the trim commands previously. Now let me use the relations also. I selected by pressing control K, I selected both merge command. Then if you go for extrude, it is possible. Okay, undo it. Let me delete this one. So we have seen both closed profile and crossed profile. Closed profile is perfect. Crossed profile, you can't make a feature, you can't make a part, right? Let us see about the open profile now. I am inside the sketch only still. Okay, so now it is an open profile, it is not closed. Let us see where it is, it allows you or not. Select this one, go for extrusion. This is coming under thin feature. Thin feature, it is not a solid feature, it is a thin feature. So that is why you put both into and a tick mark. Generally thin feature we will not be entertaining, we will not be experiencing. The open profile will be considered as thin feature with a thickness, with a sheet thickness, something like a sheet metal. So you see 1 mm thick, 1 mm thick. Since the sketch is an open profile, it is something like a sheet metal. It is a thin feature. You see the name of this one, extruded thin. Okay, but in mechanical, in I think mostly we will not touch upon, we will not require this kind of thing. Okay, this SolidWorks software is allowing, but as an engineer, better let us avoid open profile. Okay, so I'll put double tick here. Okay, so even though SolidWorks allows open profile, let us restrict ourselves only with the closed profile, not the crossed, not the open. But open profile is possible in SolidWorks. Okay, so I think this is sufficient for today's session. Maybe in tomorrow's session, we'll let us see more. Let us see more about more commands and more features and parts. Right? Thank you.